hundreds of Liberian men marched Monday through the streets of Monrovia in a colorful procession to show their condemnation of acts of rape, particularly rape of children, and to encourage the entire national population, especially other men, to commit to end rape in Liberia. Recent statistics of incidents of rape in the largest county, Monserrato, suggest alarmingly high rates of rape throughout the country, experts say. Led by members of the male college fraternity Alpha Phi Alpha, the march also included various women's groups, including the Women's NGO Secretariat of Liberia and WIPNET.
We are saying when men rape 3-year-olds, 4-year-olds, 6-year-olds, 8-year-olds, 11-year-olds, and they die, they are animals. They are animals. And we don't need them in our society because they will do it again. They will consistently do it. So we are asking for these animals to be taken away from us.
No means no. When a child says no, they mean no. When a woman says no, it means no. And so they need to report it. We just got our hotline number. It just got activated today, this morning. It's 1906. It's a CELCOM number. To report any GBV case, you dial 1906, and you will get one of our counselors on the Alpha side, and we take the case and we report it to the right agencies, and we'll make sure that we follow up to make sure the perpetrators are brought to justice.
Sexual assault is wrong. But it is particularly wrong and particularly egregious when it is done against some of the youngest in our society, those who don't have a voice, those who, because of their age, tend to be the most helpless in our society.
Our children are suffering. They are being raped. Their future is being destroyed. So we want this to be 365 days, not 16 days of activism.
Speaking to the marchers' rally at the Antoinette Tubman Stadium, Mr. Tamrat Samuel, the UNMIL Deputy Special Representative of the UN Secretary General, remarked how the scourge of rape and gender-based violence is destroying the lives of so many women and girls, and increasingly, boys.
The number of rape cases in Liberia remains high, with four hospitals alone in Monrovia treating over 800 cases of rape, predominantly child rape. In the first 6 months of this year, the problem can best be described as a national crisis.
Mr. Samuel noted that these high numbers were taking place despite many new initiatives taken by the government and its partners, the UN and NGOs, to protect survivors of sexual and gender-based violence and to bring perpetrators to justice.
Every Liberian has a role to play in preventing rape incidences. We in the UN will continue to work with government to enhance the operations of the Liberian National Police and strengthen the judicial system to make sure perpetrators are duly apprehended and tried. We will thus support ongoing efforts to develop and implement a comprehensive national strategy to prevent rape and gender-based violence, with emphasis on community ownership, as this is the surest way to both successfully and sustainably tackle the problem.
In her remarks, President Ellen Johnson-Sirleaf struck a most somber tone, comparing the alarming increase of rape to a severe sickness in desperate need of treatment.
I call upon all Liberians to see this period as a period of recommitment, to see this period as an awakening, to see how we can come together. Give us your suggestions. Parents, teachers, preachers, anyone, ordinary citizens, mothers who are affected, mothers who've lost their children, hospital workers, security agents, and they too. We ask all of them, please drop us a note. Give us your suggestion. We believe in a justice system, and we know people are declared, are supposed to be innocent except proven guilty. But I also know that people commit crimes, you must find a way to fight, you know. Bad sickness sometimes require bad medicine.
In his remarks, Dr. Federer Pratt, assistant representative of the UNFPA, underscored the need for men to work hand in hand with women to prevent rape.
I want to emphasize here that gender-based violence is an issue for both men and women. We must work to end the abuses being perpetrated in communities and behind the walls of homes all over Liberia. We must ensure that every man, woman, boy, girl have equal protection under the law.
The rally was one of many activities held during the 16 days of activism against gender-based violence between 25 November and 10 December. The Ministry of Gender is one of the main organizers of Monday's march and many of the events taking place during the period. This year, Liberia's national team is Men as Agents of Change in Ending Violence Against Women and Children. The 16 days of activism against gender violence is rooted in an international campaign to help raise awareness about gender violence and highlight its effects on women globally.